A boat has typically 12 volt on board. This is partially true, because when you charge the batteries, when the engine is running or you have shore power, you have more. You have 14 and a half volts of power. And even more dramatically, if you happen to have a windlass for your anchor or electric winches, you have voltage spikes up to 40, 50 volts. LEDs are designed to have a very long life, provided that they are fed by 12 or 12 and a half volts. And the more often you have higher voltage, like charging, or using big power consumers like the windlass or the winch, then the life goes down dramatically, and that we want to avoid. We want to put in some safety features for the LEDs. One is that you use LED that is called multi-voltage. Then on the package it says 8 to 30 volts. So this helps to save the life of this LED when charging, because charging you do at 14 and a half volts. The big spikes, the big loads, the windlass, the winches, it does shorten its life. Then you can prolong the life of a LED by means of a dimmer, because dimmers, at least the ones from Bortesteam, have an input of 8 to 30 volts and never more than 12 and a half volts output. So if you dim a nice LED tape by means of a Bortesteam dimmer, you have some sort of safety measurements against high spikes of voltage. But best of all is to have a firewall. A firewall which you use by taking a DC-DC converter. A DC-DC converter is a little black box, and you have 8 volts up to 50, 60 volts input, but never more than 12 or 12 and a half volts output. You put this black box, this DC-DC converter, by your fuses, and then you have protected everything behind that. And if you protect something that is already protected, a multi-voltage or a dimmer, no problem, even better. So protect your LEDs so you have the long life you expect from them.